Hey guys, this is Pastor Nick, and I'm out here enjoying a beautiful day in Rochester, New York. You can see it quite beautiful out, kind of an Indian summer. But I want to make this video to ask you guys to please pray for persecuted Christians in Nigeria. They're being slaughtered right now at the hands of the Fulani Muslim herdsmen and Boko Haram. There was an article that a friend of mine from Nigeria posted about this woman who was slaughtered, an expectant mother who was slaughtered by Boko Haram. I'm going to post a link to the article in the description section of this video. You can check it, take a look at it. But Christians are being slaughtered in Nigeria. The news media doesn't give a damn about them. One, because they're African, they're black, and they're Christian. Those are the three reasons why. There's a genocide of not just Nigerians, but other Christians in other parts of the world. But this is just, it's been an ongoing slaughter of Nigerian Christians for a while by the Muslims, because these Muslims want to Islamize the entire country. And it's a majority Christian nation, but you would think, based on what's happening, it's a majority Muslim country, because a majority Muslim countries, Christians are regularly persecuted, they're disenfranchised, they're oppressed, they're kept out, they're marginalized. But in Nigeria, there's that, but they're being slaughtered. And I'm not saying it's happening in every part of Nigeria. It's mainly in central Nigeria that I'm focused on, in what's called Plateau State, the Bible Belt, the Middle Belt. And people think, well, it's more complicated than that. You know, Christians are just as responsible as the Muslims. No. This is a slaughter of, and it's not just the slaughter of Christians. It's a slaughter of those who are not Fulani. So it is a tribal issue as much as it is a religious issue. So as much as it is religious persecution, it is tribal persecution. So even if you're a Muslim, if you're not Fulani, they don't like you. But especially if you're Christian. And this is according to two Nigerian brothers in the Lord that I've communicated with, that I've interviewed. And I've done, these interviews I've posted on Facebook and I've posted on YouTube. And this is what they've told me. They've educated me about what's going on there. So I'm not pulling this out of the ether. This is what's going on. So we as the body of Christ, we need to stand up and we need to pray for our brothers and sisters in Nigeria. I'm going to provide links in the description section of organizations that you can support that are helping them. And I'm going to be doing an interview, a short interview tomorrow, with one of those brothers that I just mentioned, to update people on what's going on currently in Nigeria, the current status of Christians in Nigeria. But this is a terrible, evil, satanic plot against the gospel of Jesus Christ, against the people of God. And we need to shout, cry aloud, spare not, lift up our voice like a trumpet, man. This is evil. What's happening to Christians in Nigeria needs to be exposed, and the people need to be brought to justice. The Fulani Muslim herdsmen in Boko Haram need to be brought to justice. And I don't know all the details, but I know that this is both tribal and religious, and it needs to stop. And so we need to pray. If all you can do is pray, pray. Pray and pray and pray and pray until you can't pray anymore. Because this, we have to pray. We have to pray for our brothers and sisters in Christ that are being slaughtered for their faith in Nigeria. Pastors, whole families. There are mass graves that have been dug. These brothers have family members and friends that have been killed, and their bodies dumped into mass graves. Whole villages wiped out of Christians, because again, they want to Islamize by force the entire country. Okay, so just keep the Christians in Nigeria lifted up in your prayers. Pray that the Muslims will get saved. They'll come to a saving faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Their hearts will be changed and become a new creature in Christ and be filled with love instead of hate. And just pray for the leadership, because the president of Nigeria, Muhammadu Buhari, is a Muslim. He's a Fulani, and he's behind this. I don't care what anyone says. He's behind the persecution of Christians in Nigeria. And at the very least, he's not doing anything to protect them. And it's the Fulanis that have the guns. No one else does. They don't have the Second Amendment like we do here, a right to bear arms. They don't have that. And if you try to bring guns into the country, forget about that. To give them to the Christians to protect themselves, that doesn't work either. You know, again, this is a spiritual war, and the answer is the gospel of Jesus Christ. And we need to pray for them. So let's keep them lifted up in our prayers. Thank you for tuning in. This is Pastor Nick Gentile of Lord in Christ Ministries. Christ bless you and keep you. Jesus is Lord. And I'll leave it at that for now. Shalom.